There comes a time in every YouTuber's life when you're pretty much obliged to do the same video that everybody else has done. That is, building some kind of better studio lighting. You may be able to see why. So what I've got for my lighting currently is a couple of, I think they're 9 watt, no, 9 or 13 watt. Warm white bulbs back there. Another one of the same over there. And then my cheesy attempt at a ring light back when I wasn't using my phone for a camera, which is made out of, I think they're bright white or natural white. They're not warm white, they're not cool white, they're somewhere in between. And then up here, there's this thing which is what's causing me the most grief. It's three, I think they're 5 watt cool white LEDs on a heat sink being driven by one of these LED drivers. And as you can see, they're really not happy anymore. Not sure whether that LED driver was pushing them a little too hard, or if they're just cheap crap or what, but it's time to do something about it. So, here's what I'm going to do about it. You may remember back a few mailbags, I got these 3 5-meter reels of bright white LED strips. Went down to the hardware store, got this 14-inch by 5 foot roll of flashing aluminum. Got my pop riveter, and from the same hardware store, got a couple of these shelf bracket things. Whole $1.63 each on the tag, except they were in the 50% off bin, so they cost, almost nothing. And then I'll find a power supply in my accumulation and basically make myself an LED panel to go up underneath the railroad, which is what you saw all the other lighting hanging precariously from. And hopefully I'll have a smooth, single color LED panel. And hopefully it won't be as, won't succumb to the same flickeriness as that other one. All right. Where to start? I guess I'll measure the space so that I know what I need. Okay, so it looks like from this little obstruction back here, which is structural, to the cable bundle is about 13 inches. From that beam over there to this beam over here is about 34 inches. So I'll cut those shelf support things to about 35 inches each. So I've got a couple of runners, and I'll cut the and I'll cut the aluminum a little bit shorter than that, and then we'll rivet them together and stick the LEDs on. Okay, unbeknownst to me, my battery died and I lost all the footage of me actually assembling this thing. But let me show you what I've done here. So I've got a piece of sheet aluminum cut out to the length that I measured out there. I've cut down the two shelf brackets. Pop riveted them on in a bunch of different places. I've bent one edge of this so that it clears the cable bundle, and also casts the glare, or kind of shields my eyes from the glare when I'm sitting there. Then I've laid out, I cut out a bunch of the strips of LED strip. And underneath each end, where I'm going to be soldering down the all the connections, I've laid down a bit of Kapton tape under it. Kapton tape is electrically insulating, heat resistant, tough mechanically. It's designed for this purpose. And then the last thing that I did was I drilled four holes, one, two, three, four, so I can mount it up to the structure. Unfortunately, when I was doing that with my cheap-ass drill bits, they broke going through this really lightweight steel that this stuff is made out of, and I shredded this piece. So, going to have to go back, cut it back. I don't think actually the footage that survived had this. In each of the on each of the strips, every four LEDs, there's a couple little solder pads, one for positive, one for negative. So I can cut it anywhere on one of those, and I can also splice it together on those or feed power into it, which I'm going to have to do to repair this. But I'm just going to check the rest of them. My handy dandy power supply here, and make sure everything's working like this. Is that even on? Negative, positive, that's oh, right. Okay, now it's on. Then it's good. Ta-da! All the way through. Now this one got mangled. I'm not expecting it to work. Oh. It sort of does, but just for the first set of LEDs. Okay. But the rest of them all work. So now, I can get to busy fixing this one. Yes, I know, don't pull it by the cord. I can get to busy fixing this one, and I can make up some little jumper wires to jump all the positives together and all the negatives together. And I'm actually going to do that at both ends. Just to act as a bus bar, basically. And I'm going to feed power in both ends. Just because the tracks on these guys are so thin, I don't want it to be bright at one end and dim at the other end once it gets hot. So it's probably overkill, whatever. So here's what I'm doing to create basically a power bus at each end. I'm just taking a piece of 18 gauge solid wire, which should be lots for the current that I'm running through this, and just making sharp little folds and stripping them a little over an inch apart. The LED strips are very close to an inch apart, plus or minus shaky hands and whatnot. So these should be enough. If I need to go closer together, I can just put a little kink in them. If I need to go further apart, I can just spread them a little bit. So that should do it. And I have 12 strips across the field of it. And then up on the bent piece, I have a 13th strip. So that's what that's about. This one I cut a little bit short, so I'm going to have to add a jumper on the end. But I can live with that. Now I'm just going to do another pair of them for the opposite end. Because as I said, I'm going to double feed these just to minimize current loss and voltage drop. First bend. Second bend. It's not a precise measurement, it's basically just the size of the pliers to get the little dipsy doodle there. And this doesn't take all that long, although to finish it up and do the whole bunch of them, I think I'm going to go get a beverage. And just trim that a little bit. Get my pliers, give it a nice tight crimp. And there, so those we'll just tack solder onto there, and the red one will go over there. And actually, let's just zoom in and so that one will be on there. Let's get a middle here, that one will be on there. This would work better if I was actually centered in the frame. So it's just going to look like that all the way along, times 13 on both ends. And there's the last one. Okay, so I've got a black and a red, and a black and red. And like I said, this one I'm going to have to augment a little bit, but I can live with that. That was time consuming, but it wasn't that strenuous really. Once I got rocking and rolling, it only took about 15 minutes on each one. Alright, next thing I'm going to do is just quickly tin all these little connections on the ends here. That way when I go to put my wires on, I won't have to worry about these. All I'll have to do is melt the solder blob that's already sitting there. Oh yeah, and my little repair here too. Bridge that with solder. Good. Now just carry on, and it doesn't have to be much when you're tinning. Just basically enough that you don't need to add more. While I'm in tinning mode, I'll give these things a quick tin too. Okay, now the part that I've been looking forward to and dreading simultaneously. I don't want to put too much strain on those, so what I'm going to do, hold them in place here and there with some hot melt glue, just so that they don't, and then let that cool down. Is that all soldered on? Yep, those seem to have taken. Hot melt glue to the finger. Ah. Because then this one needs to be, get a little bit of down bend on it. It does work. Except for that one right there. What did I miss there? That's my scary little piece. Okay, I gotta go in there and deal with that. I'll deal with that off camera. You don't need to watch me hurting myself. So, any guesses how much power this thing's pulling here? Guesses? 3, 2, 1. Little over half an amp. That's not bad. So I don't even, right now I'm just powering it off my PC power supply turned into bench power supply. But I don't need that. I can use a wall wart. I can use a wall wart that's rated at around an amp and it won't even get too hot. That also means that my 18 gauge wire was probably a little bit overkill, but that's okay. All that's left now is to solder some leads onto there to run down and install it. Excellent. Okay, so to power this guy, he needs about 6 feet of this 16 gauge wire. It's basically lamp cord. It's pretty much the same weight as the power cord on my soldering iron. So if I can power soldering iron, it should be fine for this purpose. A little bit of a twisty twist. And give those ends a bit of a tinning for the usual reasons. Okay. A little bit of a hooky bend. So, I'm not sure if you can see on this. One wire is smooth and the other wire is ribbed for your pleasure, apparently. So I can differentiate which one is which. Don't tilt the camera. I don't know, let's make the ribbed one the negative. Why not? Letting it cool before you release it is always a good thing. These wires have a little bit of thermal mass in them, so it takes a while for them to cool down. Melt you. Oh, I didn't pre-tin that one that I stripped off, did I? Put a bit of flux in there. There, and all of a sudden that flows beautifully. Good mechanical connection first, and then the solder just keeps from subsiding around and fills in the gaps. There we go. So, yard off about 6 foot or so of that. Enough for me to get from where I'm using it down to the ground. And a couple of bits off those ends, just so we don't have fraying bits going everywhere and causing sparkiness. This unintended sparkiness is not cool. Okay, camera adjustment. So what did I do? I made the ribbed one ground, so that's that one. Put that into that binding post. And that means by default, the not so ribby one is the positive. Put that one into that binding post. And, haha, brightness. And actually, Now that I'm using heavier wire, not just those clip weeds, that's actually more blinding to my eye. And there it is installed. Now then, let's see what the bench looks like with it. Gotta have that running. Wouldn't be my workbench without that guy running. Okay. Now then, let's plug her in. Oh, that's nice and bright. How does that look? Here's that old LED that I had mounted on a heat sink. I'm not sure what to make of these guys, if they're completely toast or what. I'll deal with that at some other time in the future. But I think it looks pretty good in real life. I said these are cool whites. So, oh, that looks okay. That's readable. It's actually very even across here now. I think that's going to work. So there we go. The inevitable YouTuber project that everybody apparently has to do. I've done it. Now I can get back to the fun projects. Thanks for watching. Talk to you later.